SpaceX, the company best known for its innovation in rocket technology. And of course, straight out of science fiction, booster landing. While SpaceX rockets are dominating the space race, it's not going to stop there. The company has future plans to enable point-to-point travel on our blue planet. So let's discuss, how will SpaceX completely change the aviation industry in today's video of DiscoverZen. We all know about SpaceX. It was founded in 2002 by Elon Musk, with the goal of reducing space transportation costs to enable the colonization of Mars. SpaceX has developed several launch vehicles, the Starlink satellite constellation, the Dragon cargo spacecraft, and flown humans to the International Space Station on the SpaceX Dragon 2. The most popular rockets include Falcon 9 and the Falcon Heavy. The company's achievements include the first privately funded liquid propellant rocket to reach orbit, the Falcon 1, in 2008. The first private company to successfully launch, orbit, and recover a spacecraft, Dragon, in 2010. The first private company to send a spacecraft to the International Space Station, the Dragon, in 2012. The first vertical takeoff and vertical propulsive landing for an orbital rocket, Falcon 9, in 2015. The first reuse of an orbital rocket, Falcon 9, in 2017, and many more. SpaceX is a pioneer in rocket booster landing and reusing it. And currently, they are working on a new rocket named Starship. The spacecraft and Super Heavy rocket, collectively referred to as Starship, represents a fully and rapidly reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo to the Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars, and beyond. But according to SpaceX, there will be different versions of it, and one of them would be for Earth transport. To know more about Starship, click on the I button or the links in the description. Now, let's look at how the Earth transport version of the Starship can disrupt the aviation industry. In the SpaceX video that illustrates the idea, passengers take a large boat from a dock of a city coast to a floating launch pad out in the water. There, they will board the same rocket that Musk wants to use to send humans to Mars by 2024. But instead of heading off to another planet once they leave Earth's atmosphere, the ship separates and breaks off towards another city on Earth. Just 39 minutes and some 7,000 miles later, the ship re-enters the atmosphere and touches down on another floating pad, much like the way SpaceX lands its Falcon 9 rockets at sea. The routes proposed in the video include travel from Hong Kong to Singapore in 22 minutes, London to Dubai or New York in 29 minutes, and Los Angeles to Toronto in 24 minutes. The proposed method of Earth City to Earth City travel would be, by far, the fastest ever created by humanity. Musk told us the ship would reach about 18,000 miles per hour at its peak, which is more than an order of magnitude faster than the Concorde. Elon Musk's idea of Earthbound space travel isn't some crazy concept coming out of the blue. It's all a part of his greater plan to make humans a multi-planetary species. If SpaceX only has one product that can be reused under a wide range of scenarios, and everyone is willing to pay for that service it provides, then Elon will not only be able to use that money to pay for his Mars invasion, but also achieve the necessary economies of scale to drive prices down to the point at which full planetary colonization would be entirely possible over the next century or so. At least, that's how the theory goes. And he has also said that SpaceX is doing some crucial things to make this business model happen. Safety is obviously a critical part of this concept. SpaceX wants the Starship to have the same safety stats as the airline industry. That is a high aspiration, but a critical one if they want to achieve his colonization and air travel objectives. You need thousands of launches and landings to be able to make it to Mars, Elon pointed out. To achieve that, the rocket will have redundant engines for landing, four big vacuum-gimbaled engines that can slowly pivot, and two sea-level, smaller, gimbaled engines that can pivot quickly to redirect the spaceship for high-precision landing. In theory, the Starship will not only need two of the big engines, but one of the small ones to land safely. Musk claimed that the reusability, combined with the payload capability, will make Starship the least expensive rocket ever made. When you factor in the expected life of the design, there's no competition with any of the launches available today, even with SpaceX's own rockets. The Starship will be able to handle re-entry under a wide range of atmospheric and payload conditions thanks to its delta wings and gimbaling rocket engines. Their physics simulations showed that the new rocket system will allow for the proposed supersonic re-entry, deceleration, and precise maneuvering needed to land safely on Mars, Earth, and the Moon. The Starship can also service the ISS or any other station in Earth's orbit, Moon orbit, or some other place on the way to Mars. In fact, Musk claims the ship is big enough that it has necessary fuel capacity to fly to the Moon, land on a moon base, load some cargo, and get back to Earth without refueling. If he fulfills these promises, the design could keep money flowing into his company. Now let's talk a little bit about the new engine used in Starship, the Raptor engine. The Raptor is the most ambitious engine ever made in the history of mankind. It is powered by a subcooled liquid methane and subcooled liquid oxygen using a staged combustion cycle, unlike the simpler open cycle gas generator system. The closed cycle makes the engines extremely powerful and up to 98% efficient. SpaceX Raptor engines began flight testing on the Starhopper prototype in July 2019 and became the first full-flow stage combustion rocket engine ever flown. Raptor also produces the highest combustion chamber pressure ever reached by an operational rocket engine at 330 bar or 33,000 kilopascals. So things are looking good for the Starship, but how will the amenities inside the Starship be compared to airplanes? And also, what are some of the landing concerns? We don't know what the passenger experience is going to be like, and that's an important factor in a scenario like this. The thought of blasting off on a rocket to space is so exciting, as is the potential for adding moments of weightlessness to your trip to London or wherever. But will people actually be willing to put their bodies through this kind of extreme stress for the sake of shaving off a few hours of their trip? And then there's the landing. Despite occasional hiccups, airplanes land with overwhelming success. To its credit, SpaceX has gotten really good at landing its Falcon 9 rockets both on land and at sea. And Musk even began his speech by touting how 16 of them have landed successfully in a row. But the difference between landing a 14-story rocket booster with no passengers and a large ship full of them is one Musk will hopefully expound upon, either during his presentation or next time he opens Twitter. Now let's talk about Boca Chica, SpaceX's gateway to a Mars city. Well, actually, that sounds like something we're going to discuss on another episode of DiscoverZen.